that there be peace among all beings of the universe. Let there be peace, let there be peace. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Namaskar, Namaskar. Welcome. Yesterday we were speaking about renunciation. And you have seen by renouncing everything, yet the renunciation was not complete. Because whatever one renounces does not belong to oneself. Abandonment of house, relations, everything doesn't belong to oneself, so it was decided to renounce the mind, and renouncing the mind, freedom can be attained. Now, you have not asked the question, what is the mind? Where is the mind that has to be renounced? You ought to have asked this question, to renounce the mind, to renounce everything. Renounce something, you must know what you are renouncing. So this is the question, what is the mind that you have to renounce? So whatsoever effort you make, you can't find the mind. Ego is another name of the mind also. And this is the ego that gives trouble to a man. Separation, union. Everything that is appearing is just mind. All this universe is nothing but mind. Thought. When it rises, the universe rises. Separation rises. Union rises. You are happy with union and in grief in separation. All due to mind. But what is the mind? Have you ever tried to find what is the mind? Or what is the ego? Everybody says give up the ego and give up the mind also. But whatsoever effort you make, you don't find the mind, neither ego. So what is it that you have to renounce to make a total renunciation to be free? So by doing this renunciation, you are instantly free. As quick as you close your eyes, so quick, so without any effort. Closing the eye doesn't need any effort, nor opening the eyes. So it is effortless. Now you find out what is the mind. Accept your own notion. Accept your own ideation. What else the mind is otherwise? This is only your notion. And it comes into function when you desire something. So your desire is mind. When you want anything, then the mind comes into operation. And if you check your desire for single instant, then there's no mind, there's no ego, and no samsara also. This is your own creation. This union is your own creation. Separation, your own creation. In consciousness, in emptiness, there is neither union nor separation. You have seen yesterday, a young boy was suffering because his brother died. ideation, idea, notion. So, if you check this notion or ideation, idea is just idea, notion is just notion, and nobody has seen what the notion is. Likewise, this mind is a notion. When you want something, it operates. When you want this or that, the universe is created. And when you don't want anything, as in the sleep, you don't want anything, there is no universe, no separation, and no union. And you are free for some hours. Again, next morning, again the universe rises. Why? Because the seed of the mind was not destroyed. You slept with this seed, and this seed is the next morning's waking state, is this seed which will sprout and again become a tree like samsara. Never it is going to end. Unless you destroy the seed of samsara, seed of the mind and seed of the ego. So, living with a teacher or meditating on this notion, on this ideation, you will destroy the seed all at once. And simply doing away this mind for temporarily, that is done every night when you say, and what is the seed that you have not destroyed before sleeping? Which is the seed? Mind, ego. I am going to sleep and I will wake up early next morning to do this and that. So this and that is the seed. So and so is the seed. And if you don't sleep with this and that, then you have destroyed the seed completely. But when you go to sleep, you say, I sleep. And I wake up. This is the seed of samsara. So you have somehow, before sleeping, don't be afraid that you will not get up. You will get up a wise man, not ignorant man. That is the difference. Wise man can live without mind, and ignorant man lives with the mind. That is the difference. And this mind gives trouble forever and ever. Not even after death it's going to leave you. So if you destroy this concept, this idea when you go to sleep, kill it before, slowly meditate before sleeping. Even don't wish that I am going to sleep. This I am going to sleep is the seed. Meditate before that. And then sleep will not overpower. Something else is going to take you into fourth state, neither waking nor dreaming nor sleeping. You will be transported to fourth state that you have never heard nor even experienced. So in fourth states, don't be afraid that this waking state you are going to lose. This sleep state you are going to lose. Or even the dream state you are going to lose. All these things will be there and you will wisely look at these three states projected within the consciousness, and you are the consciousness in the fourth state, you are the consciousness, and these are the ripples afloat on the surface of the ocean of consciousness. So how easy it is for those who are wise, and if not impossible, yet very difficult for those who are afraid of their own consciousness, of their own self, or even afraid of happiness. They want momentary pleasures and are happy, and then hunt after some other pleasure. Any pleasure of the senses is not permanent, not abiding. You can just calculate from this, whatever pleasure you have, it is fleeting, it's not abiding. Therefore, you are aspiring after something which is not reality. If it is a real search for reality or freedom, it is going to abide forever. So search for that which is not known to you yet, and you are surely that itself now. You are consciousness itself. But when you cling to your body, this is the ego and this is the mind. So if you want to get out of this cage once for all, this is a trap. I am the body is a trap. No one can come out of it except few. Instantly you can get out of it, out of this trap of samsara. Samsara is never-ending trap of suffering again and again for millions and millions of years. And some wise one here and there, like Buddha has done it, instantly sleeping in the midnight, he wakes up. And that was all. Instantly, he rode a horse out of the palace of pleasures, wife, son, treasure, elephants. So this was the decision. Once for all, he finished everything, he rode, contact the horse. It is so sad, the horse also treaded so softly on the earth that the gatemen, the jailers at the gate did not wake up even. Such was the compassion of the horse even. And his name is still alive, Kantak. And after the crossing the frontiers of the state, he petted the horse and he did not return back. He attained salvation by a single stroke of his hand on his head. Now go back. He died instead. So this is a decision you have to make. The Siddhartha became Buddha. You are all Buddhas, don't forget. He was a prince. He was an ordinary human being. You are all. He could do it because he decided, he has seen birth, he has seen disease, he has seen death. And that's all his sutra which he has read was only for the first time he goes out of the palace. And he saw only a sick man, old man, and a dead man. This is the sutra for the first time he read and calculated, this is all suffering. I have to get out of this trap. And he did. Not only he himself, but many thousands of people are being benefited today. We speak every day. 2600 years ago he lived at the very place, in this state itself, where you are sitting. He had treaded this place. Yes. So this is all. Do not have any notion, any kind of notion, for 1 second and see. Tell me if you are not Buddha. But we cannot get rid of oceans and we notions and if, because we want to suffer. We like to be born again and die again. And somehow we fall in love with this trap itself, we cannot leave the trap. Wait. Start. I am leaving today. Help, help, help. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Annie. I have two requests. Number one, take away my mind. Who's Annie? Annie or something? His name?
Annie.
And second, a little hello to Gauri to take back to Taos would make her so happy. When are you leaving?
Today.
This afternoon. It's okay. Why you want to give me your mind? Why?
We could make a trade. I give you my mind, you give me enough for worrying.
What? Why you want to give it to me?
I don't really want to give it to you. You don't want it.
Do you like her?
Who?
Do you like the mind?
No.
No?
Nuisance.
Nuisance? Okay, you want to give me the nuisance, okay. Okay. Give me that. Give it to me. You don't want to give also and say. It means you like it, no? If you don't like, give it to me. Give it to me. Say I have given. Why don't you keep quiet?
I give it to you.
Why? Say I have given away.
I have given away.
That's all. That's all is over. If you give away something, it doesn't belong to you anymore, you see. It doesn't belong to you anymore. So you have given away, just as some beggar comes in front of you for alms, begs something, and you have $1, give it to him. He goes away. then the dollar that you were having is no more with you. And you can't get back from the beggar also, he's gone away. Will you run after the beggar? Give me back the dollar, will you do it? No. Like this thing, what is given is given. Take care now. It's enough. Do you have it now? No. Are you sure? Okay. It's enough then. That's all. Because there's no mind at all. Simply you say there is mind, then you get trouble for nothing. It was not there, it is not there. Simply you say, I have a mind, and then when you have a mind, it gives you trouble. Then throw it away, and no more it is there. Neither it was there, nor you have given away to someone else. And you are happy also with this. Simply you are happy for nothing. You have not done anything. You didn't go to Himalayas for long penance. You didn't sit under the Bodhi tree at all. Simply give away the mind and you become Buddha. Instantly. And this is Buddha got after his penance for a long time, 7 years he spent, simply to give away the mind. It took him 7 years. And here you are getting instantly, immediately, in a second, in a moment, you see. And this Bodhi tree is a decision. Decision that I have thrown away my mind. And this decision you have to take today, tomorrow, in this lifespan, and if you have not decided, you will repent very much for this thing. You will have to repent for nothing. Already you spent many generations to be here in satsang, and still if you can't get rid of this, then you will have to repent. This time may not come again. Make the best of time. One satsang is quite enough to throw away the mind. What is satsang? To get rid of the mind. Mind is a problem. It has given problem to heroes even. Heroes, fighters, warriors. And instantly you decide, I want to be free of the mind, and you are at peace. This depends upon you, your decision you have to take. This life, next life, postpone. And when you postpone it, again, this is the mind, you need a mind to postpone. And if you don't have a mind, you cannot postpone. Postponement means mind. Anything that you postpone, you need mind. If there is no mind, instantly you are free. And you can't be free with the mind, you cannot be free. So it is good that you have done it. Sit somewhere there if you like. Scotland. This man's Jill Carolyn is here or is from Scotland? It's not here. I am
coming to visit you. No, it's not here. In October. And I thought, before coming, I would write and introduce myself. My name is Jill. I come from Australia. Though I am at present traveling in England and Scotland, I met Gangaji last year while visiting my sister in Boulder and sat with her again in satsang this year in Boulder. Papaji, I want more than anything to be free, to drop my personal story of suffering, to be joyful, longing, and be happy. I know that the only impediment is my own mind. So he knows that impediment is mind, is thinking, my own ego, and I know that you can show me the way to be free, truly free now itself. Respectfully yours, Jill Caroline. So, this girl knows that the suffering is only her own mind and ego. This girl knows in the letter. So, you do not know the suffering is caused by mind. If you know it, then something could be done. Mind is the source of suffering. Because when you sleep, there's no mind and you don't suffer. When you could do then, why not now? You don't believe...
Because I don't sleep. Because I don't sleep. Now.
You must sleep.
It always was this way.
So if a man doesn't sleep, you know which is his best place to stay? If a man who doesn't sleep just for 3 nights, you know where he is sent to?
To the bed, I think.
Huh?
To the bed.
Space.
To the bed. Bed.
Bed?
Bed. 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 B-E-D. Bed.
Bed.
He is sent to bed.
And which is this place in your country? We have it here, every country has. When you don't sleep, and the other people send you there for indefinite period. You can't get out of it.
For indefinite?
Period. Period. Indefinite time.
Yes.
You will be staying there. Always thinking, thinking, and thinking. And that is the place for the stubborn mind. And we have here. We have in Lucknow also. So I will wait and see what happens. We are so many people, we will take you there. And they will take care of you. And there you will be very happy and joyful. I have gone to such institute and I entered. I wanted to see one doctor there. And then I entered in the gate. Everybody is coming smiling. Smiling to me as if they know me. So when I go to them to return their love, and they start, there's no reaction, only laughing, you see, for no reason. Then I met my friend who was a doctor in Thana Medical, Thana Mental Hospital in Bombay, Thana Mental Hospital. So he says, if a man is not happy outside of this prison, everybody is happy here. They become happy. I do not understand why they are happy. Everybody is smiling, very loving, very joyful. How it happens here? So here we have, in our state also, if you visit next Taj Mahal, the same city is famous for this also. There is one Agra Mental Hospital. This is the address, you see. And that you will enjoy your friends. If you don't like these friends, you will like those friends. So this is the symptom of mad people, you see, those who don't check their thoughts, don't check their mind. This is the symptom of mad people. And all this universe is a mental asylum. Whole universe. Who's wise? Some here, there, somewhere, may be found one, maybe another, that's all. Among 6 billion people tonight, may not be 6 people who are really happy. Just 6, 1 per billion. Maybe a man who is really enjoying himself, who is happy, peaceful, joyful. Just 1 per billion, you see. So it's not for everybody, you see. To be mad, it doesn't take anything. But to be wise, you have to find here, there, some Socrates, some Buddha, someone else, you see. Those who are really wise. Yeah. So it's not in the luck of everyone to be happy. Everybody knows suffering, how to suffer, everybody knows. Everybody likes it also. They like suffering. Because I saw one man from France, Paris, I saw him in Rishikesh. And then I told him, I used to tell the same things here. Then sitting in front of the Ganga, so I said, Michel, don't you enjoy these waves of the Ganga? Some fishes are playing. And why you are always monotonous, always suffering, thinking? What do you think? He said, I am a teacher in University of Paris. I am a teacher of philosophy. I am not supposed to smile. If I smile, my students will think that I am mad. So if even I am happy inside, I have to hide my happiness to show that I am very serious professor of philosophy. So I can't afford to laugh like you for nothing. So we have not been taught in France to smile and laugh for nothing. And if we do, our parents, our friends, our society do not accept it. So from the boyhood, we learn this, how to be serious. The parents suppress us not to show your happiness. Even on the table, the breakfast table, they say, if we lift this fork in a wrong way, and then they are very unhappy with us, angry with us, and sometimes slap us. It's not the manner. You have to do this thing and not that thing. So from the from a young age itself, we are suppressed by the parents not to show our happiness, you see. So this is carried on. So somehow, if you go to some place where you can find a happy person, better stay there. This stubbornness will leave you. It may take you some weeks or a month. Stick to it if you want. You have suffered already a billion years to wear this dress. Billion years it has taken you to wear a human dress. Not everybody. Billions and trillions are other things you see in the world. How many mosquitoes, flies, fishes? And you must be thankful to nature that you are wearing this human form. Thankful. Don't waste this life, you see. In being stubborn, don't waste your life. And if you get to occasion, you will see someone by luck.
Did you get that?
To see someone who can speak like this thing, don't go the way of destruction, be happy, sit here, to be in satsang. This is a rare merit, you see. So it's better not to waste it, you see.
Not to
waste this chance.
Yes.
As you say, this chance.
Yes.
Don't waste it. It may not come. Next dress may not be human dress. Could be any dress, you see. Where you can't even think. Now at least you can ask, I am stubborn. At least you will not know. So, my dear friend, give a thought to it. Give your attention to this. Since coming here and sitting in satsang with you, I have experienced more peace and quietness than ever before in my life. Then a few days ago, I had to go to Delhi for some business, and almost instantly upon arriving, the monkey was loose and gesturing in the treetops, chattering in the treetops. And if that wasn't enough, he brought all his friends and relatives, and I felt like they all had me by the tail. And then back to Lucknow and in satsang, and immediately the joke began to quiet down. Is it a joke or what? Anyway, he's come and read himself. Gurupad.
far away. And then back to Lucknow and satsang, and immediately the noise began to quiet down. What's going on? Am I somehow fooling myself about this beautiful quietness? Old habits sometimes come up to take you back again. This is going to be your test. Your test, you see, most people will be washed away with this test, just to try. Old friends, if you suddenly give up drinking and you go together at the bar, and suddenly you decide, you hear on the TV from Surgeon General that it causes lung cancer, throat cancer, and you immediately, many people stopped it on his interview on this television, and instantly I saw the effect, because it was authority speaking, Surgeon General of States. So if he stopped, other people come. Come on, let's go. He said, no, I will not go. Oh, doesn't matter. He tells them, no, about this thing I heard. Oh, he is a foolish man. What does he know? What does he know about this taste? Come for one day more. He goes again and forgets, and then starts again, you see. Old habits, you see. So it's better to keep quiet, you see. Give up the association for some time till you are strong. You are listening to this girl from Italy, also same thing. Give up. Better to keep quiet for some time, and when you feel very strong, then you go into the battlefield. Then only, well equipped, when you know the art of battle, then you go and face your enemies. Otherwise, these things, but they are welcome. Most of the people will not fight in this battlefield. No, they will not, you see. It's better to be injured in the battlefield than to run away as a coward man into the latrines, you see. Better to be injured and die on the battlefield fighting, you see, than to hide themselves. This is one way of living, and one way of death also. You have to face, you have to be very strong. It is for the warriors, see. It is for the warriors, not for the cowards. Just to be free, to become free, is for the warriors. All the warriors have won this game. They have been all warriors. You can listen. Arjun was warrior. Archer. Yes. Almost all the kings have been warriors who got enlightenment. They knew the art very well. They could not be deceived. So those who are deceived, so they can be trained. Can be trained, everybody can be trained, but it's not for the cowards. It's not for that tribe of the cowards. It is for the race of those who belong to the battlemen. And few are there, you see. Few are warriors, not everybody, you see. All the rats are businessmen, isn't it?
Thank you.
Beloved Papaji, thank you again and again. I hear, or I read, or I feel your sweet message. You are already free. Be blissful as you are already are. It's so very easy. Being in your presence, there is understanding. But if it is so easy, why I have to understand it again and again, or forget it again and again? Krista Prem, please come. So this message that you hear, or read, or you feel, is you are already free, isn't it? And you are bliss itself, and it's so very easy. But if it is so very easy, why I have to understand it? I have never said in the above message you have to understand it, have I? Message is so simple, you are already free, and I don't tell you have to understand it. What is there to understand? In bondage, you may have to understand why I am bound, why, what did I do, what sin did I commit, what crime did I do, so that I am put in prison. That you have to understand, and you will find the cause. But to be free, what have you to understand? And forget it again and again. What you understand, that only you can forget. And what you don't understand, how can you forget? What you have understood, that you may forget. But if you have not understood at all, how can you forget it? But where did you bring this? It's very simple. You are already free. Then this understanding, the concept of understanding, where did you bring this but from? You are already free. After that, but. Where this but has come from? But has come from because you want still to understand. And this cannot be understood. Therefore, but, what, if, when will arise. And it is so plain, you see, you are already free. What you have got to understand? Why to question about your freedom? You are free, fly away. That's all. Fly away. So now again I tell you, you are free. You have been free. You would be free. Now speak to me. Now you have only say, I am not free. I have never been free, I would never be free. This is all you have to understand now. So what's your problem? You are here face to face. Resolve your doubts and resolve your buts and whats.
I created doubts by imagining sitting there.
Yes, but who created I? First you have to think about I, then we will see where God is located. Isn't it? First you must be there to pray to God, isn't it? And this has been told to you by the church, isn't it?
Yes.
Yes, God is the construction of the church. Out of church, is there any God? Tell me. Out of church, is there any God? God is in the church and church is in the God, that's all. And without church you cannot conceive of any God. So therefore, demolish the concept of church. Then find out what is left without the church, what's left. Church means concept and fear of God and sin and heaven and hell. This you learn from the church. So if you have no concept of church, what's left? Are you not free? For a while, little while, for one moment, one second, you get rid of the concept of church, only church. Church means faith in something, isn't it? That you have heard from someone to do it, to follow it, otherwise you will go to hell if you don't. And if you do, heaven is presented to you after death. After death, who knows what is going to happen to you after death? Why not to sieve for your own self now? So be free of all concepts, number one. Number two is to accept I am free. Then I am bliss. In this very moment you have got to do it. Don't postpone. And religion means postponement. Come to church today and tomorrow also. And this is a promise also to come to church tomorrow, because this is the promise from the God seated in the church. Food for the morrow I shall provide, isn't it? Yeah. So don't accept these gossips. Now find out. Yeah. Find out here and now. The truth is here and now. You need not go to any church. And truth is all that you are. Truth is you, what you are. You are not to attain it by any church, by any prayer. You are truth itself. This is what I say. And now you have to prove this is not true. If you know something more, I will learn from you. Yeah. Yeah. Any problem now? No? Very good. This is good. Come and sit down here and tell me if there's any problem. We will speak. Yeah. We'll speak. Yeah. Anything comes from the past? From the past? Anything? When nothing comes from the past, this is called freedom. Bondage is past, no? Buried in the memory, you see? So if you are quiet now, all the memory will be burnt. Yes, you simply keep quiet. You see, there will be fire in the memory and it will be burnt. Millions of things stored in the memory will be burnt. Immediately, in 1 second, you can burn it. You can burn your past. And you can burn your time also. Time. And mind also. This is called freedom. You will be out of time. You don't need time. Again and again that you said is time only. No time. And time is mind also. And mind is past. And past is graveyard. Past is graveyard, you know. You can go and see the graveyard. Everything is past.
Thank you.
Looking for love, looking for love.